Good morning. Good morning to everyone.
All right. Was yesterday's hearing what you expected?
Finally, we've come to the end of the franchise hearing, and finally they reserved the best for the last. And what do you mean by this? Finally, we've come to know the real reason why they want to punish ABS-CBN by denying its franchise, and that is certain congressmen want to be able to dictate the content, the way that ABS-CBN reports on news events. And they ask, is ABS-CBN biased? Yes, ABS-CBN is biased in favor of public accountability. ABS-CBN is biased in favor of giving voice to the voiceless. And ABS-CBN is biased in favor of reporting the truth. And that is what is at the heart of this matter. And if they're going to punish ABS-CBN for being biased in favor of the truth, that is a form of subsequent punishment. And it is interpreting and enforcing the law in a way that abridges the right to a free press. That is why this has become a right to a free and independent press.
Okay. What was interesting is the fact that people were actually waiting for Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano's issues against ABS-CBN on the way it handled the election coverage in 2016. And yet he gave a statement. He did not testify. He didn't ask questions. Do you believe that ABS-CBN was able to clear the air with all the accusations that was brought out earlier on, but yet yesterday's hearing did not focus exactly on how ABS-CBN does its processes in covering the elections?
In covering the elections, and we were all there, we were all witness to how ABS-CBN covered it. There were debates, and every candidate was given airtime. So whatever complaints that Speaker Cayetano has, maybe it was over the advertisements. Mm-hmm. I really don't know, but I really wanted him to air that, and his statement that the congressman should vote according to their conscience. Maybe the congressman should vote according to the interests of the people who elected them to power. Maybe the congressman should vote taking into account what people need. And what people need is access to information right now. So 69 million Filipinos are deprived of access to information. Perhaps the congressman should think about that. Maybe they hate ABS-CBN, but they should not base it on their personal emotions, but they should base it on what people need at this time.
Mm-mm. Okay. Congressman Marcoleta bringing up specific headlines that ABS-CBN had written. Congresswoman Garin bringing up coverage. Also another congressman saying how he was hit, this and that. Did you see the hearing as an issue of personal vendetta or, frankly, an opinion on how ABS-CBN you should do its job?
It is an attempt to dictate how ABS-CBN should report news events. Regarding what former Undersecretary or former Health Secretary Garin said regarding the Pangasinan reportage, that had been corrected and sanctions have been made on the reporters. So that is what distinguishes ABS-CBN or an independent and free news media from other ordinary groups, and that is, out of 100 stories, you could make a mistake in one story, and right away it is corrected. Mm-hmm. And regarding the headlines that Congressman Marcoleta pointed out, I think this had something to do with the legislative franchises which he authored, which was reported and based on congressional records. Now, if there was something wrong with the congressional records, then what Congressman Marcoleta should point out is that there's something wrong with it. And that was, I think, aired by ABS-CBN. So what is important here is that out of 100 stories, if you make one mistake, you immediately correct it right away. And that is the duty of a free press.
Okay. Now, Congress Representative Sato said franchise hearings should not delve into content, because content, actually, we do it by self-regulation. And we follow a set of rules in journalism. We have an ethics code. Complaints, actually, she says you can go to court. And if not, this would amount to prior restraint by discussing content regulation in the news.
Correct. If there are any complaints, if they think that ABS-CBN violated the law, the regular courts can be resorted to for the filing of cases against them, any report that ABS-CBN had done. And also the MTRCB also has jurisdiction over content, over theme, horror, etc. So it is the MTRCB and the regular courts that have jurisdiction over content. regarding the congressional hearings, they have jurisdiction over franchises, which is the granting of airwaves and frequencies.
All right.
The attempt to transform this hearing into an effort to dictate content or to dictate the way that ABS-CBN is reporting news events show us that this is really a form of being able to control and dictate what the news media should report on. And it is very frightening because if they can do this to ABS-CBN, they would do this to other news media organizations. So I hope that the 46 congressmen who will vote on the franchise would vote not just according to their conscience, but according to what the public need, what the public needs right now, and that is access to information on matters of public concern.
All right. On that note, unfortunately, Attorney Lambino, we don't have enough time, but I want to thank you for your thoughts this morning, ma'am. Thank you.
Maraming salamat.